What is going on, everybody? Welcome to another edition of Old School RuneScape's Luckiest Players. In this one, we are going to be checking out our luckiest players from the month of November in the year of 2020. Now, before we get into this one, I want to reiterate what I have said in past videos. I will not accept cell phone pictures. They're grainy and they look nasty and they're hard to work with. So if you submit cell phone pictures, they will be immediately deleted and not considered. Additionally, I am getting a lot of submissions without the RuneScape name that fully visible in the screenshot. I like to give credit where credit is due. So if you can't submit a picture with your RuneScape name in it, it will not be accepted. But if you do have a screenshot that meets all of the criteria for these videos, you can send it to the email address on the screen right now. In the subject line, put something that it will identify it to me and maybe give me a little bit of backstory in the body of the email. If it makes the cut, it will be featured in an upcoming Luckiest Players video. Last thing I want to mention before we get started, I have went back to combining the Iron Man and normal account drop submissions to one video. I thought that I was taking up too much time throughout the month with content like this, so I wanted to move everything back to one video and constrain the drops a little bit more so we really only see the luckiest stuff instead of stuff that might be a little bit lucky but not super lucky. So with that, Iron Man and normal accounts will be featured in this video. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into these lucky players. As usual, we're going to start off with the clue scrolls, and in this section, the Third Age submissions. Unfortunately, we only had 3 Third Age submissions for the month of November. Doesn't look like it was dropping too much, but first up is going to be the Iron Man Black Dahlia on the 10th hard casket of the account, pulling in the Third Age Vambrisses. Clue is worth around 4.3 million GP. Next one comes in from another Iron Man, Schick, and this is going to be a Third Age Kite Shield on the very first Elite Casket of the account, 25.669 million on the value. Now the next one, I know this is supposed to be for the month of November, which one of these is, but we're going to throw the old one in here anyways because it's still pretty amazing. First Master Casket on this account, all the way back in August of 2019, Therapy Dog pulls in the Third Age Druidic Robe Top. At the time, it was worth around 1.1 billion GP. And then over a year later, but only 10 Master Caskets later, pulling in a Third Age Druidic Cape or Cloak on November 15th, 2020. So 11 Master Treasure Trails, 2 Third Age drops. Down at the bottom, we can see the collection log there for XLuxX, who is Therapy Dog now. You can see the highlighted Third Age Robe Top and the cloak. That's pretty crazy. I mean, that's billions in GP there. Really incredible. Now, next up, we also do have a couple more Third Age submissions, but these come along with the Mimic boss. First one comes in from Sarah Doman, pulling in the Third Age Druidic Robe Top, 1.5 billion GP, and this was on the fifth Elite Casket of the account. Unfortunately, we can't see the Mimic kill count there, but I'm gonna imagine it was probably 1 or 2KC or pretty low with only 5 Elite Treasure Trails done on the account. The next one comes in from OSE420, and this is gonna be another Third Age Druidic Robe Top, and this is also gonna be around 1.5 billion GP, and this one comes in on Mimic kill count number 2, Elite Casket number 15. Very nice drops, very nice submissions. You guys are incredibly lucky to be pulling those out. So now we can move on to our other clue scroll drops, and these are still pretty incredible. We're going to start off down with the medium clue scrolls. Iron Man Magenta Lamp 3 pulling in the Holy Sandals on just the second medium casket of the account. Next up is going to be Sword 7 on medium casket number 15 and 16 pulling the back-to-back Ranger Boots. Next up is Benty 15 with a medium casket number 2 spiked manacles. And the next ones are all 1KC mediums. First one from the Hardcore Iron Man M. Cowles, 1KC Wizard Boots. Next up is Convey West with Ranger Boots on the very first medium casket of the account. And rounding out our medium clues is going to be Pizza Boy Zach, who is an Iron Man with the 1KC Ranger Boots. Next up is our hard caskets. First one comes in from Hardcore Iron Man Please No DC. And this is going to be a double Robin Hood hat plus Guthix boots on hard casket number 33. That's pretty cool to see for an Iron Man. Next up is Iron Man Mr. Rot, Hard Casket number 3, pulling in the Gilded Kite Shields. Next up, Iron Man Nana with Hard Casket number 1, pulling in the Gilded Plate Legs. And up next, we have our lone elite submission for the month of November, and this is going to be from Boo Bah Babe, Elite Casket number 4, pulling in the Gilded Coif. And last but not least, we're going to check out our luckiest master clue scrolls. First one comes in from Cleet G2, sorry if I mispronounce your name, pulling in the Double Occult Ornament Kit on the master clue scroll. Unfortunately, we can't see what master casket this is, but regardless, 7 rolls on the clue puts the drop rate of this at 1 in 14,641. And next up, we have a trio of 1KC masters. First one comes in from Nixu, master casket number 1, grabbing the Tormented Ornament Kit. Up next is going to be Boo Bah Babe again with another Gilded drop, Master Casket number 1 with the Gilded Axe. And our last submission for the Clue Scrolls in November is going to be C137RS pulling in that Bloodhound Pet on Master Casket number 1. That is a 1 in 1,000 drop from Master Caskets. So that is going to wrap up our luckiest clue scrolls for the month of November in 2020. We're going to go ahead and jump right into our luckiest PVM item drops, and we are going to start out with our low KC drops. First one comes in from the Iron Man ASAP Robbie, 37KC Dragon Warhammer. That's 1 in 5,000 on the drop rate. Next one from Cooker Rulers, 31KC Skeletal Visage from Vorkath. And that's a 1 in 2,500 drop rate for either Visage, or 1 in 5,000 for a specific one. Next one comes in from TJ Wolfpup, 31KC Elijah Sigil on the duo completion. Questnoob C with a 28KC Twisted Bow, 15,357 personal points. 21KC Dragon Warhammer from Lord Jaywis. 21KC Blade of Saldor in the normal gauntlet from Late Ring. 9KC Skeletal Visage from Terp Nerd. 9KC Dagon High Hat from the Iron Man Iron Cock. 8KC Primordial Crystal from X Boober X. 6KC Tanzanite Mutagen from VBN Darts. 5KC Jar of Souls from CRC4AU. 3KC Bandos Tacits from All Frido. 2KC Staff of the Dead from EZG. 2KC Ceridoman Hilt from Hugens. 2KC Primordial Crystal from Gavin the Grey. 2KC Odium Shard 2 on the Iron Man Do Air Humk. 2KC Jar of Dreams from the Nightmare from Pressy. 2KC Berserker Ring from G Thug Nasty. Another 2KC Berserker Ring from the Iron Man Abyssal Whip. 2KC Armadillo Chestplate from Raffle Ross. So that is it, and we're going to move right into our luckiest PVM item drops, and these are going to be our 1KCers. First up on the 1KC drop list is going to be Overspec with a Zamorakian Spear. Next up is Find My Meme with a 1KC Ceridoman Hilt and managing to grab an Armadillo Crossbow just 10 kills later on 11KC. Next one from My EXP Drop, going to be a pair of 1KCs with the Hydroclaw and the Zamorakian Spear, plus really lucky on the 1,900 point Dragon Claws from the Chambers of Zarek. Next one comes in from Hixby and another duo 1KC, Bandos Tacits and a Ceridoman Sword. Lyra Lacqua with a 1KC Primordial Crystal. Evo Silva the Iron Man with a 1KC Armadillo Crossbow. P. Swells with a 1KC Twisted Bow, very nice. Yumbles with a 1KC Dragon Hunter Crossbow on just 1,007 personal points. Bud Knight the Iron Man with a 1KC Blade of Saldor from the Normal Gauntlet. I'm not sure how to say this, Kagathi? 1KC Zamorak Hilt. Iron Grun the Iron Man with Bandos Tacits. Juki Hori with Bandos Tacits. Mr. Blue 102 with KBD Heads. Juggernaut with a Ceridoman Hilt. And last but not least is Zombax with the 1KC Arcane Sigil from the Corporal Beast. Moving right along, we're going to jump into our PVM item combo drops, and these can be like a few kill count apart or just incredible drops to see all together. First one comes in from Zepsi, and this is going to be 3 Primordial Crystals within 118 kills. KC 1662, 1698, and 1780. Next up is Young Bog with an Abyssal Dagger and two Abyssal Whips and just 148 KC at the Abyssal Demons with a 506 KC total on the collection log. X Rock with three Smoke Battle Staffs and an Occult Necklace in just 120 Thermonuclear Smoke Devil kills. University with two Hydra Claws in just 51 KC. That's 1 in 1001 on that drop rate. Twisted Faith with two Dragon Warhammers by just 843 KC, 1 in 5000 on the drop rate there. Next up is Tobfather with an Avernic Defender Hilt and Lil Zik in the same kill at 465 KC. Next one comes from the Iron Man Sampu, Dragon Pick from King Black Dragon, 314 KC, and just several kills later at 323 KC. Next one is going to be Solo Kev, two Solo Twisted Bows with an 11 kill count, KC 1479 and 1490 in the email. Solo Kev said that that was the last item needed for the collection log completion. Next one comes in from Snuslockin, and this is going to be two Primordial Crystals within 7 kills, which Snuslockin didn't get any until this first one on 875 KC, and then managed to grab another one at 882. Next up is Sense Lacking, two Dragon Warhammers in just 96 Lizardman Shaman kills. Next up is Rizzo DNB with three Basilisk Jaws in just 135 KC. Next up is the Iron Man Rada Nixa with a completed bludgeon at just 66 KC. Make Me Famous with the Bomelet in the challenge mode Chambers of Zarek, 630 KC, pulling in the T-Bow and the Omelet Pet on the same kill. JMDE the Iron Man with three Dexterous Prayer Scrolls in 57 KC on 24, 57, and 81 KC. High Anxiety the Iron Man with an 18 KC Arcane Prayer Scroll and just 8 kills later a 26 KC Dexterous Prayer Scroll from the Chambers of Zarek. Halo Song with the Hell Puppy and the Smoldering Stone in the same kill at KC 255 at Cerberus. Grace Nelm, the Iron Man with four Zenites, completing the Iron Man log for that in just 170 Demonic Gorilla kills. Next up is Fresh Out with a 4KC Dragon Pickaxe, 36KC Dragon Pickaxe, 39KC Pet, and a 49KC Dragon 2H Sword from the Chaos Elemental. Frankie Flo with four Hydra Claws by 115KC, managing to grab these on 13, 33, 44, and 115 KC. Easy 200 mil. Next up is Freeze, 394. Three Armadill Skirts in just 39 KC, managing to grab these on 11, 27, and 36 KC. Sorry about that, 36 KC. Dothkin, managing to pull in a Draconic Visage on KC 513 and a Skeletal Visage plus the Vorkath's Head on KC 587. Pretty nice to get those out of the way. Next one from Iron Man Dead Wish Joe with an ancient relic from a Goblin Revenant. And no skull drop rate on that is 1 in 29,320. And the skull is 1 in 16,126. So regardless, incredibly rare to see. And you can see the Runelite tracker over there. 421 Revenant Goblins. Next up is Creed Apollo with a Jar of Swamp and a Magic Fang in the same drop. And our last combo drop here is going to be from Condor the Iron Man. Zulra completion for the Iron Man, no duplicate drops in just 152 total KC. Next up is going to be our last section of PVM item drops, and this is going to be our back-to-back item recipients. First up is going to be Tim's Mining with a Staff of the Dead and Zamorakian Spear from Kirill Susaroth at KC 659 and 660. Spacer Stefan with a back-to-back Zenite Shard at KC 12 and 13. Sylvia S15R with a back-to-back Bandos Tacits and the Bandos Hilt at KC 696 and 697. Ron Swanson with a back-to-back Cowfight Queen Pet followed by the Cowfight Queen Head at KC 133 and 134. Outsider with a Berserker's Ring, KC 62 and 63 from Dagonoth Rex. And I decided to throw this one in here just to follow up Outsider's back-to-back. Outsider changed their name to Hunleft Please managing to pull in 6 Blades of Saldar in just 682 Corrupted Gauntlet KCs. That is a 1 in 400 drop rate, so seeing 6 of them in that amount of time, really pretty, really cool. Next up is KPC with Bandos Tacits on KC 327 and 328. Next one comes in from H2O Whippin with back-to-back Dragon Hunter crossbows. This was submitted for Sloppy First, who was the recipient of these drops. Dragon Hunter crossbows on 363 and 362 Chambers of Zarek. Eric Wild with back-to-back Bandos Hilt and Tacits, KC 5 and 6. Ego Lifter with the back-to-back Callisto Pet and the Dragon Pickaxe on KC 29 and 30. DD Bow, the Iron Man, with a back-to-back Primordial and Pegasian Crystal at 62 and 63 KC at Cerberus. Daft Aunt with Jar of Chemicals and Dragon Knife on the back-to-back KC 456 and 457 at the Hydra. Border 21 with a Dragon Pickaxe and Tyrannical Ring, plus another Dragon Pickaxe, the back-to-back Dragon Pick and Tyrannical Ring on 41 and 42 KC, plus 7 kills later, another Dragon Pickaxe at 49. And last but not least, Bajau with the back-to-back Ancestral Hat and Twisted Kit from the Challenge Mode Chambers of Zarek on just KC1 and KC2. Moving into our next section, we are going to check out our luckiest PVM pet recipients. And starting this one off, once again, is going to be Outsider with a 36 KC Dagonoth Supreme pet. Drop rate on that is 1 in 5,000. Next up is 35 KC Vorkath pet from EZG. 30 KC Nightmare pet from Yusuk Dude. 26 KC with a King Black Dragon pet from R410A. 23 KC Vorkath pet from Papa Smurf. And another 20 KC Vorkath pet from Manuel. 17 KC Callisto pet from Fresh Out. 16 KC Cerberus pet from Del Fuego. 14 KC King Black Dragon pet from the Iron Man Janae. 12 KC Grotesque Guardians pet from High. 7 KC Chaos Elemental pet, and this was from the Fanatic from E-Flame Put. The Fanatic drop rate is 1 in 1,000 compared to the Chaos Elemental itself, 1 in 300. 6 KC Venonatus pet from Tata Barahona. 6 KC Kriara pet from Irish Hallion. 6 KC Kraken pet from Cursed Idiot. 5 KC Vedion pet from Reese 2. 5 KC Dagonoth Supreme pet from Monciani. 5 KC Abyssal Sire pet from the Iron Man Just Bones. 4 KC Vorkath pet from CB104. 4 KC Giant Mole pet from Urzu Rider. 4 KC Corporal Beast pet from X HamsterCom. 4 KC Corporal Beast pet from Patton Mages. 2 KC Cowfight Queen pet from Shurima94. 2 KC Jad pet from Zemarek. And a 2 KC Gauntlet pet from Rate Steiner. And just like our PVM item drops, we have our 1 KC PVM pet recipients. Starting this one off is going to be Boneless Rice with the 1 KC Theater of Blood Lil Zik pet. Next up is Dustin with the 1 KC Hydra pet. Fran Levstick with the 1 KC Jad pet. Grumpy Poo with the 1 KC Giant Mole pet. Infinite Lux pulling in the Scotizo pet on just 1 KC. Next one comes in from Nan Flipper, and this is going to be the Scotizo pet on 1 KC, and then pulling in a Jar of Darkness on just 8 KC, and then duping the pet by 8 KC. So you got two pets and a Jar of Darkness from Scotizo with an 8 KC for Nan Flipper. Renato Potato with the 1 KC Kriara pet, and last but not least is Silly Queefer. I can't imagine where you guys come up with these names. Silly Queefer with the 1 KC Jad pet. Rounding out our PVM pet section is going to be some awesome combo or multi pets. First one comes in from CJ, pulling in 3 Verzik pets before any other uniques in the Theater of Blood. 38 KC, 3 Verzik pets. Next up is going to be Sam Squash 19 with back to back Jad pets, and this was done off task, so it's even rarer. You'll notice there in the screenshots that it doesn't say the Slayer task was complete, so we know it's off task. Next one comes in from Rep Wheels, and this is an Elite Clue, a Dark Totem, and the Skotos pet, all in the same kill from Scotizo, 1 in 41,600 on that drop rate. Next up is Zhao Douglas. 3 mole pets within 184 KC. Honestly, I just finished the giant mole myself with the pet. I don't even know why you'd go back there after you get your pet. There's so much better things you can be doing, man. Next up is Elor Drill with 2 Cerberus pets within 5 KC, pulling the first one in on 286 KC and then another on 291. And our last PVM pet submission comes from Airy, 2 pets on November 14th, managing to grab the mining pet while mining in the gem rocks under Shiloh Village and then pulling in the omelet with a dexterous prayer scroll at KC 129. So getting 2 pets in the same day, that's gotta feel really good. I hope that happens to me. Moving into our next section, we're gonna check out our luckiest skilling pets, and this is usually a short section, so we'll breeze right through this one. First one comes in from Instigate Mass, and this is gonna be a level 68 woodcutting pet from the yew trees. Odds of that at level 68 are 1 in 145,313. Next up comes from Papa Rieg, 56 agility pet from the Falador rooftop course, 1 in 25,406. Level 54 runecrafting pet from the Orania Altar. The base chance for this is 1 in 1,487,213 per essence. Obviously, that does go down depending on the essence you have in your inventory. This one comes in from Big Daddy Jovo, so grats on that runecrafting pet. Next up comes from Iron Man Bot By The Way, level 53 thieving at the fruit stalls, 1 in 122,741 on the odds. Next one comes in from Vinish, 3 runecrafting pets by just level 84 runecrafting. All 3 of these pets were gotten at the blood runes, that is a base chance of 1 in 804,000. Next one comes in from Iron Man Vinoli. And Iron Man Vinoli managed to grab the Heron pet while doing the Tai Bo Wanai Trio quest. You can see all the quest items there in the inventory. That's really, really lucky. Next one comes in from Ruku Spuku, and this is an Iron Man. 2 agility pets. First one got at level 35 at the Varrock rooftop course, 1 in 23,535. And then just a little bit later at level 42 at the Canifus rooftop, 1 in 35,792. Next one comes in from Eagles Rule 3, and this is going to be a 2KC Phoenix pet. And last but not least, you might remember from the last Iron Man episode, the 0XP Rocky pet. Well, somebody else has done that at the Skirk Juice. 0XP Rocky pet for Iron Slum. Very cool to see. So that's the second one of those I've seen. All right, so that is it for our luckiest players of November in 2020. So now we're going to move into my favorite section, the unluckiest players. And why do I think this is my favorite section? Well, because I know these feels and I understand. First one is going to come in from Vasa Disaster, 3,000 Hydra KCs with no Hydra leather. That drop rate is like 1 in 500 and something. So 6 times the drop rate feels bad, man. And our next one comes in from TYVM, and TYVM, or thank you very much, has put in 3 unlucky submissions, and this really feels bad. First one, 151 KC in the Inferno, no Zuck pet, and most of these KCs were probably done on the Slayer task, so that's a 1 in 75 drop rate for that one. And also, no Jad pet, 207 KC. I mean, that sucks, man. But if you thought that was bad enough, no Calphite Queen pet for TYVM, 12,597 kills. I hate this boss. I hate Calphite Queen so much. I only do 25 KQs per task of Calphites that I get for Slayer. And just seeing this kill count makes my brain physically hurt. I cannot imagine staying there this long and not getting that pet. 1 in 3,000 on the drop rate. That's over 4 times the drop rate with no KQ pet. More power to you, man, but I couldn't do that. Next up is going to come in from Extra Poor, and this is no Bottomless Compost Bucket. 177 Hespori kill count. Now that takes 24 hours to grow a Hespori, so 177 days without a Bottomless Compost Bucket. Really, really bad, man. Next one comes in from Fenko, And this was actually pretty cool. I haven't seen anybody do this. Fenko has used 10,030 of the enhanced crystal keys on the Elven Crystal chest, trying to fill out that collection log with the Dragonstone armor. And lots of dupes in there for the plate legs, the gloves, and the boots, but no helmet. So that's a lot of money spent. It's like a billion GP on making those keys, and to only get about a 500 mil return on that with no helmet, no completion on the log, feels bad, man. Next one comes in from MyGov Gamer. No Thermi Pet, 16,000 kill count. 5 times the drop rate on that pet, cannot manage to get it. 167 occult necklaces in there. Good lord, man. Next one comes in from Zoof. Finally managing to grab a KBD pet at 5,678 KC. Long time over the drop rate, almost double the drop rate, but managing to grab it. But even still, spending that much time there for that pet. Congrats, man. Next one comes in from Gimme Pets. 1,223 KC at the Chaos Elemental. Finally managing to grab that pet. That is one of the easiest pets in the game to get, by the way. 1 in 300 on the drop rates. Going over 4 times the drop rate there. Finally managing to grab it. Next one comes in from Baked Player. Pulling in the 1 KC Dragon Spear from Bandos. Imagine going to Bandos, your first time ever, and getting a 1 KC Dragon Spear. 1 in 5,628 on the drop rate, which is much rarer than any other Bandos item you might see there. Next one comes in from JustaNoob75, pulling in a back-to-back Jar of Dirt at the Kraken. Drop rate on that is 1 in 1 million, and they are worthless. Next one comes in from Badion, and this is a Phoenix pet at 4,098 Wintertot KC, 101 million fire-making XP it took to get that pet. So 50% of the way to max XP took you to get that pet. I guess congrats, man. I kind of know your feel, because I'm like 3 million fire making XP over 99, and I still have not managed to get those Pyromancer boots. And last but not least is going to be Belier Rossi, who submitted last month, you might remember this, 4,638 KC at the Hydra without a pet or a claw. I guess being featured in last month's video maybe gave the dude some luck. So 1,156 kills is what they have done since the last video. Pulled in 3 claws in those 1,156 kills, but the unlucky part is still no pet at 5,794 KC. All right, everybody, that is going to wrap up the luckiest players video for the month of November in the year of 2020. Remember, if you have something that you think will make the cut, send it to the email address that you saw earlier in the video. If you like the video, please leave a thumbs up down below. And if you'd like to support the channel, don't forget to tap the subscribe button on your way out. Additionally, if you really like the content, you'd really like to support the channel, you can become a channel member by joining the channel. You will get exclusive access to channel member only community posts and exclusive in-game events with me. So once again, guys, thank you for watching. I will see you on the next one. Take it easy, everybody.